be here today. What I wanted to speak about today is, I know we have a lot of lectures about the religion, the philosophy of spiritualism, but today I really want to talk about the science of spiritualism. I wanted to get more into that vibration. We all really think of the science of spiritualism as we're going to go to a seance, we're going to do table tipping, we're going to do trumpets, we're going to do all this phenomena. I always knew in my life, my mother used to always teach me that the science starts as a spiritualist inside of you. Starts here, inside of you. Because you start to make the journey. Because as spiritualists, we are all on a journey. No matter how we perceive the journey, how we walk the journey, we all have that vibration within us to start the journey within us. And I've taught classes about the healer or the medium must heal themselves before they can heal others. They must heal this vibration, the vessel that we carry within this vibration and into this earth plane. And we have to kind of realize where we're going, where we perceive we need to be. As a science, we're trying to discover, trying to prove the religion of spiritualism, to connect to the spirits on the other side. In my readings, I really don't try to go into spirit guides because they're not really provable, unless you actually know your spirit guides. You really don't. I can tell you your guide is somebody, but unless you actually know your guide, it's more provable mediumship. It's kind of connecting to a higher source, understanding that. But first, you must clear this vessel, this vibration, so you can attract a higher energy within your auric field. You must be able to attract something higher within your vibration. Because the energy that you put out into the spirit world is what they read, what they connect to. We had a medium at Casadega one time, and she was a trance medium. And she came from up north, had all this big work. And I remember Lolly Weigel, Marie Lilla, Eloise Page, we were all sitting together in the background. And this lady said, I want to trance Jesus today. And she put her hands out like this. And all of us could see these three guides behind her going, you were Jesus last week. I'm going to be Jesus this week. We could see them behind her, and we were just kind of giggling, but because she was attracting spirits, but not the one. But the question is the provable, is the connection, is working with spirit, changing the core situation within you. And when you do that, when you follow the journey, because we're all on this journey in our lives, this journey, and we're on a journey for ourselves. And when I teach my classes, I teach you to read like you, to heal like you, not to be like somebody else or some other connection to something else, but how you perceive the spirit around you. Because if I allow you to be you, then you will stay in the work. If I force you to do somewhere else or do something else, you're not going to probably stay in the work. You'll get discouraged and you'll walk away because you can't see spirit. You can't connect to spirit because I'm trying to teach you my way. But I want you to learn that. And my mother always taught that to me when I was a child. She sent me to my grandfather's house, and my grandfather was full-blooded Cherokee. So he taught me how to read rocks. Read Cherokee smoke readings, rope readings, all kinds of things. While I stayed with him, he taught me how to do these different types of readings. Then my mother, she was a spiritualist, but she taught me all kinds of different ways of how to read with tarot, I ching, runes. I spent a lot of time my life learning that. But that's mostly when you learn situations, whether you learn sound, whether you learn this, it puts it in your psychic vocabulary. Puts that in your vocabulary. So when you are dealing with spirit, spirit works with you with those symbols and things that you have already within your system. Symbols belong to you, and it's what they mean to you. It's what they connect to you. It's how you perceive that vibration within your life. So try to figure out how you work, how you sense spirit. Are you sensing? Are you seeing? Are you smelling? Are you hearing spirit? Where are you at because I want you to kind of realize that you are the conduit the Spirit works through. You are it. And I had a lady come and tell me the other day, she says, Lewis, I passed a spirit about 6 months ago. I died for 12 minutes, but I did not see the white light like everyone else. And I told her, I said, a lot of the times when people are not ready to see the light or see the white light, guides will overshadow you, protect you, guide you, protect you until you're ready to see what you need to see. So usually the blackness or the darkness is just a covering to protect you until you're ready to see what Spirit wants to see. Now, I've always had Spirit overshadowing me throughout my life. So ever since I was 3 years old, I've seen Spirit. And I just thought everybody did, but that was after I went to school, I found out that it was not that. And then my father would take me into, he was a Baptist minister out in Volusia, he's a Baptist minister out in Volusia County. And he'd always stop me out in front of the church, he'd straighten my suit and straighten my little tie, and he'd go, now listen to me, I don't care if you see dead people, I don't care who you see, don't you tell anybody in this church what you see. And then he'd know, I'd tease him, I'd sit in the audience, I'd go, and and my mother used to take me to all the spiritualist camps, at that time, to work the spiritualist camps. And she used to work a lot of the different places throughout the United States, and I used to travel with her. Most of the camps now are gone that I used to attend and be at. They're gone now. But the question is I had all this expertise of different modalities within my life, understanding how they work, and I set my psychic vocabulary. And that's really what I really want you to do, is the science is actually figuring out this movement with you, the vibration with you. You have to raise your vibration to see Spirit, to connect to them. You have to meditate, you have to start the journey. See, we as spiritualists are on our own expedition into the unknown. That's where we are. We're standing at a force that no one has ever traveled. And we are forging our way down that path. And we as individuals are going to see the path that we're supposed to see. No one's ever walked there with you. And as we venture further and further into the spirit world, Spirit will show us more stuff. They will open another door. They will connect us to something else. They will show us something. And that's really where we want to get. We are on the last frontier of moving into what it works for us. Because I can't wait to meditate. I can't wait to talk to Spirit. Because I don't know what they're going to do next. I don't know what they're going to propel towards me next. Or what they're going to show me. And that's the intriguing part of being a spiritualist. Because we can't really blame it on someone else, what's happened in our lives. Because we don't, we have only ourselves to connect to. It's us and our guides and protectors around us. And through my whole life, I've always had spirits sitting around the bed. And remember, I explain to people, you have control of spirit. They do not need to wake you up at 3 o'clock in the morning. They don't know you need to get out of bed. They don't need to run you around the house at 2 o'clock because they just said so. You need to tell them what you expect from them. If you allow it, the Spirit will do it. Give them rules. I have like safe words. Don't do that. I have years ago, a Spirit used to run out and jump in front of my car while I was driving. I had to make him stop. It scared me. See, somebody hitchhiking, all of a sudden he'd walk in front of the car. That scared me. They had to stop. Guides will sit around my bed at night, and they'll be real quiet. And then you can hear them. I can hear them. I go, I think he moved. I think he's up. I think he'll talk to us. I go, no, I'm not up. Because Spirit wants to speak to you. Either consciously or subconsciously, they want to speak to you. But it's the Spirit you attract through the vibration you put into the spirit world. It all starts with you. You can join a congregation, you can be part of the congregation, everything else, but still, each one of you are your own individual. You're raised the way you were raised. You're connected to spirit the way you connect. And I want you to blossom in that direction within your life. Whatever you do as you call your spiritual work, I want you to realize that that is your real, whether it's through music, whether it's through readings, whether it's through healing, whether it's through music, whatever you feel is works for you, then do that. Because we want to encourage people to be in this religion. We want to bring you into the religion. But we also want you to understand that the philosophy, the religion, all this still comes down to the science of it. Is we're proving our religion, we're proving who we are, we're working with ourselves, we're connecting to a higher source. And we as spirits, those who have been in this for a while, we know there's spirits. We know that spirit is alive and well on the other side, working with us each and every day. And I explain to people, you need to understand who's working with you. Who's connecting to you from the other side? What guides, what people are connecting to you? I always found out in my life the major guides within your vibration should be your gatekeeper, your physician, and your alchemist. Your three guides. The ones that actually open the door, let people in. The one that actually wants to work with you and heal you. And the other one wants to manifest things in your life. You should get to know them. You should get to know them. Because those are the ones that are actually manifesting things within your life. And learn, we read the principles, we read our healing prayer, we read the principles, but those are only a guideline. Those are a guideline for you to kind of look at, to connect to. That's what they're for. Because you're going to read something different than I read it. You're going to get something else out of it than I did. I learned that years ago. My father used to make me read the Bible. He didn't make me read it, but he made me read it. But I think I've read the Bible probably about 85 times from cover to cover. And I understood that my father would read things that I, not how I saw the verse, not how I saw it. Or I would turn to different pages of the Bible and go, what about that? He'd go, we don't read that part of the Bible. I said, okay. What about that one? Because he would always tell me that I need to let these people go. Remember, you don't hold people here. You don't hold people here. You don't make them stay. Everybody has their own free will and choice to be here. They didn't come from the other side because you forced them to be here. That's not it. We don't force people. If I try to force some of you in this audience to do something against your will, you would probably hurt me. Because you will not do that. But we as spiritualists, we have to believe that through spiritualism, through science, through the proving of spiritualism, to the proving of this stuff, to doing the seances, to doing the readings, to raising our vibration and teaching, we can help you get yourself to where you need to be on that level. Remember, when you attract spirit, think about light within your body. And the brighter the light, the higher the spirit. As long as you raise your vibration and raise the light, the higher the vibration will enter your auric field. If you just put out this low energy of the vibration, you're only going to attract that kind of energy within your vibration. So allow yourself to raise it. Allow people in your life to go away. Some people just need to go somewhere else. They need to find a new home. Don't put yourself in situations in your life that will pull you down. Walk away from them. God bless them and walk away. My mother should say, you don't wish anybody harm in your life. You just, when they win, you just wish they win the lottery and move away. Wish they just go somewhere. But don't put yourself somewhere so it drains your energy, drains the vibration in your life. Because you want to raise it constantly throughout your vibration to keep yourself healthy. To keep yourself in tune with spirit, to keep yourself where you personally need to be. And health is a given. You're supposed to be healthy. Healers can sit here and do the healing, and do all that on your vibration, but you personally have to accept it. They already know that they've healed you. You just have to accept the healing. So you have to accept the gifts of spirit. And that's where it all comes down to, is accepting the gifts of spirit, accepting who you are. I'm not going to tell you not to read a certain way or do something a certain way, because that's what works for you. It's what clicks for you. It's what makes you who you are. I'm not taking that away from you. But I want you to truly understand that the principles, philosophy, the science of this religion are gateways to take you to where you need to be. It's only a couple, three maps here that you get to read and decide what path you take. Tell people our paths and our lives are very easy. You can be dragged, you can walk, or you can ride with them up. Your choice. How you arrive where you're supposed to be. You have to decide that. And decide who you have in your life. Decide where you're personally going to be and make yourself happy. Because if you're happy and you're connected to spirit, then the spirit guides around you will be extremely happy too. And your loved ones and people that have passed to spirit, they're actually rejoicing within the vibration. Because what you do here affects there, as above, so below. And I truly believe that the things that my father did tell me, knock and the door be open, ask and you will receive, and these things I do, you will do greater. These things I do. And if we understand that we can do great things, awesome things. And I've been in seances with some very extraordinary mediums. I've seen people drop out of the ceiling. I've seen energy build up in the center of the room and come out in the room and drop a full-grown tree in the center of a seance room. I've seen stuff throughout my life that I can't go and say, well, I didn't see that. It was there. It was there. And I've been through a lot of this throughout my life by working with spirit and connecting to them. And that's where you have to be, is to sit in the quiet, in your quietness. How you perceive, how you get quiet. And then allow spirit to work with you. There are many teachers on the other side that want to work with you. Not just the teachers here in the spirit and this physical world. It's the teachers on the other side that want to work with you. That want to bring you to a higher vibration. When I pass to spirit, I'm going to come back and I'm going to run around your vibration. I'm going to scream in your ear. I'm going to pull stuff off the shelf. I'm going to throw it in front of you and I'm going to make you look. You ever walk in a bookstore and a book fly off the shelf at you? That's because spirits are walking ahead of you and go, read this. Do this. Because spirit has a way of wanting you to look at something, putting something in motion. I laughed the other day. I was in the Castigo Hotel and I was talking to a lady there that owns the hotel. I said, you know, I'm really looking for some really awesome speakers in my thing. She said, well, we have an awesome speaker, but she's not here right now. All of a sudden, she showed up. There she was. I'm going, oh, hey, give me a business card. Because spirit will produce people when you need them. We'll put them on the path in front of you. We'll put them there. Spiritualism is a religion of self, of you. You. It also is a symbol of watching, of understanding what's in front of you. Spirit doesn't just come and throw it in front of you. A lot of the times you have to play 20 questions. You got to follow the breadcrumbs. The spirit will drop things in front of you. You have to watch for the repetition in your life. If you want health, ask for perfect health. Or the reason why not. Or the reason why not. Because if you're doing something, you're a vibration, your daily life, that doesn't constitute perfect health, I don't care how much health you ask for, you're still doing the bad thing in your life, you won't probably get the perfect health. So ask for perfect health, the reason why not, and watch what spirit does for you. Ask for what you need to do. Tell them You picked all of them before you got here. You picked your journey, your destinations in your life. Your free will in this life is only how you arrive at that destination. That's your free will. You picked the destination already. You picked it. You picked who is going to be in your life, what's going to happen. All this stuff is how you arrive. You want to arrive standing up, or do you want to be duct taped and dragged behind a car for a couple months? Your choice. That's your situation. But people understand that. I've done readings for a long time in my life, a lot of readings. And people never surprise me what they put themselves through in their life. What they put themselves through. And they go, it's not my fault. They put themselves through that. And you have to really understand that you chose. You can always get out of the car. You can always do something else or move in a different direction. The energy within your life is supposed to be awesome. Awesome. Remember that. God loves you every second of the day. So, I know that through my life of listening to Spirit and working with them. Because when I work with Lucerne, my trance guide, when he comes through, he comes to this old vibration and I leave. I constantly actually leave. And then, but they teach me. They work with me on the other side while I'm out of body. And they work with me. They always start teaching me something or talking to me or doing something. But I always tell people, before you get into all this work, discern the Spirit. Discern who's speaking to you. Discern it. The messages should weigh themselves out. Even if they don't connect to the Spirit right away, the message should weigh itself out. It should make some kind of connection to the individual. If not, address the person bringing the message. Ask them, why isn't the message working? Why? You need to talk to Spirit and talk to the individual at the same time. You gotta chew gum and walk at the same time to be a medium. So if you can do that, you'll be a good medium. You gotta chew gum and walk at the same time. That's what you gotta do. Because you gotta talk, you gotta talk. You gotta ask Spirit questions. You gotta question them, discern the Spirit. Because the higher your vibration, the higher the vibration you're going to pull over and around your life or field. There are plenty of people on the other side that want to work with you. I've told you a little of the things I want to fix with people, because sometimes people teach you that I have people that think their message bearer stays the same. Over the years I've been doing this, I've been doing reading since I've been 10. I'm going to be 66 here pretty soon, so I've been doing them for a while. My message bearer will change in different situations. My message bearer might not be able to talk somewhat to some of you because you don't want to hear. So somebody else will step up and speak for them. So your message bearer doesn't stay the exact same individual every time you get up and give readings. Not every time. So if you say, well, my message bearer is so-and-so, she's here with me all the time. They change because of the group of people. Situations with people, they change. Same thing with your healing guides. They don't stay the same because your one healing guide might not be able to work with somebody. And somebody else, a doctor or somebody, will step in into your auric field and overshadow you and bring the energy through that will cure that vibration. If you're having heart trouble, you don't want a podiatrist behind you trying to heal it. You don't want a foot doctor trying to heal a heart problem. You've got to attract who that needs to do that. So remember that when you're doing meetings, when you're connecting with people. You can get to know your guides, but don't get so guide fixated in your life when you're doing mediumship work that you can't do the work because the guide disappeared. So guides fixated, you gotta have them in your vibration before you can do it. Allow yourself to find the avenues in your life that you truly, absolutely feel comfortable with mediumship. Because mediumship is not for me to give you readings. It's not for anybody else here to give you readings. mediumship is really for you to contact spirit on your own. I can't follow you 24/7 and go, what you doing? What you up to? I shouldn't be doing that. But understanding how you speak to spirit will help you on your own path. Like having your own GPS in your hand, guiding you on the path to where you need to be, as long as you have that connection. And the connection's for you. And that's really what mediumship is. I don't think mediumship was ever supposed to be to give readings. It was to teach, to instruct, to help others to have that communication with spirit. And I still believe another 5 years, years from now, you won't have mediums. You'll have teachers, because everybody will be open. They'll just want us to teach them how to control it, how to bring it into more conducive. I'm getting more students now that already see spirit. They're already connected. They just want to know how to do it. How do I fix this? How do I do this? So we're going to be teaching, instructing, helping. But if you're in contact with spirit, then ask your guides, discern them, work with them, feel the vibration. That's what you need to do. Because I want everybody to be a spiritualist. Everybody. I laughed the other day. I went into a large conference. A lot of ministers from different religions. I had this great big tag on me. I love Casadega. Some of the Baptist ministers wouldn't shake my hand, but that was all right. I still was in the room. Didn't kick me out of the room. So I was there having breakfast with them. Had a pastor's breakfast. So the question here is, put yourself out there. Don't be afraid of the religion. Put yourself out there. Allow spirit to work with you. And teachers will find you. Teachers will find you. There's plenty of teachers here. I love people that go all the way over to England and find their